गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम सूरज अग्रवाल एंड यू आर वॉचिंग योर फेवरेट यूट्यूब चैनल गार्डनिंग इज माय पैशन। टुडे फ्रेंड्स, वी आर इन द ग्रीन व्यू नर्सरी एंड द सीड्स हियर इन दिगिर पार नियर कोलकाता। दिस इज स्पेशलिस्ट इन ऑल द एडेनियम ग्रोइंग एंड ऑल द प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ द एडेनियम प्लांट्स। सो नाउ वी आर लर्निंग हाउ टू टेक केयर इन द विंटर मंथ्स all the five basic principles how to maintain the adenium, and this is Mr. Sanjay Mondol. He is the owner of the nursery and he is telling me that the five basic principles how to maintain the plants in the winter months. So this is the challenge everyone faces, the challenge of the maintaining the plants, adenium plants in the winter months. There are the harsh conditions for the, these are all the desert plants, they cannot maintain all this in the winter months. So he'll be telling me five important points how to maintain the winter. Just keep on watching. I am telling you one by one what are the five important points. Just keep on watching. Thank you. So friends, point number one, you have to keep your plants all in poly house, as because the plants are in the desert conditions and they maintain the plants, you can maintain above 20 degrees centigrade. You have to maintain the poly house temperature more than 20 degrees centigrade. These are the all poly house you can see all in the roof side, and the sides also you have to maintain all the poly house. And in poly house, only in poly house you can maintain 20 degrees centigrade. And you can see the leaves here, lush green leaves, all are totally deep green leaves, all our leaves are fresh here. You can see these are the all fresh leaves, and that's also green leaves, and all the seedlings are there. So they are totally maintained 20 degrees centigrade, and up to January end you have to maintain in poly house. And after January, when the temperature, outside temperature is 20 degrees centigrade, more than 20 degrees centigrade, inside is 20 degrees centigrade, then you can remove the poly house. So I am showing you, this is the poly house at the roof area, and totally, and the front area gate also, this is the poly house here, and I will be pulling it down to the here. So this is the covering of the poly house, and I am closing the poly house here gate. So this is the gate, and all you have to maintain in the poly house. So this is the point, every side and corner you have to maintain the poly house, poly thing you have to cover it, so can you can temperature maintain. So friends, I am showing you, these are not maintained, kept in poly house, these are in open air condition, and you can see all the leaves are fallen here, all the leaves are shed, and small leaves are there, these are in open, all the winter conditions. This is the condition in the winter time. So if you want to maintain all the plants leaves and all detailed condition, you have to keep the plants in the poly house.
Plants are kept in a poly house. The total house is covered with polythene. You can see the polythene cover is entire house from.
So friends, as you can see, these are the multi-grafted plants. You can see these are some of the tablet grafting, some of the V grafting here. This is number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6. Sieves grafting are there. And here also you can see, this is the one grafting here, and second grafting, third grafting, fourth grafting, and lots of grafting are there. And in every branch you can get different colors of flowers. So this is the plants here you can maintain. And I tell you, the watering is a very much important in the winter seasons. And if you are growing in the cocopit, only you have to water at after 3 days or 4 days or 5 days. And if you are maintaining very well drained soil with the bigs of all the sand or the gravels and all these kind of things where the water drainage is very high, then only you can water it in alternate day. Otherwise, water it very sparingly in winter months, because they don't need much of the water in the winters. So this is the important point of watering in the winter months of the adenium. So friends, point number 3 about fertilizing. Fertilizing or giving the foods of the plant in the winter months, they don't need much of the food. These are the all adenium arabicum plants. You can see these are lots of, and here flowers are also here. These are the desert plant, adenium arabicum. And if you want to give the food only in the winter months, they goes to dormant conditions, they don't need food. But it all, if you want to give food once in a month, that is only 19:19:19 NPK. That is only in foliar spray you can give. If you are, they have the plants, they have the all the leaves are there, and you are keeping in the all this in a poly house, only you can fertilize with 19:19:19 NPK, half teaspoonful in 1 liter of water, and once only in month. These are the plants you can give the fertilization with 19:19:19. This is the point number 3. So friends, these are all Adenium somnolens plants, and the speciality of this plant is it can attain a structure of a tree and can attain up to 30 feet tall. These are plants you have to grow in the ground, and this will attain 30 feet tall Adenium somnolens, and these are basically the Adenium plants in the all the monsoon time or in the early winter months. They are attacked by the fungus attack. You can see these are the, all the fungal attack. If there is a severe fungal attack, you can apply 2 gram per liter sap or Babistin fungicide. You can apply and spray it once in 2 weeks, that is once fortnightly. You have to spray fungicide, sap or Babistin or similar kind of contact or systemic fungicide or the mixed of systemic and contact fungicide once in 15 days. You have to spray here totally, and you can spray in the soil also fungicide. This is the point number 4, apply of fungicide once in a fortnight. So friends, these are the all the plants, Designer Adenium, and 3 plants are grown and interwoven, twisted to each other. You can see these are the beautiful pattern of plants here, and lots of plants are there, and they cost around 300 rupees to 400 rupees each, and they are a nice design, and they will flower, nice pattern and nice coloration, and you can give 2 to 3 plants in different colors. This can give you the pattern, and I am telling you the 5th point about the pest attack. You can get the pest attack for the aphids or maybe mealybug or some of the green bugs also, they attack here, and you can use Simbus or Rogor or Hamla or Simbus or Kaka. This kind of similar kind of pesticide you can use 1 ml per liter, 1 milliliter per liter, and use it once in a month. So there will be no pest attack at all, and all the plants will be total fresh all year round. So this is the point number 5. If the insects attack, you have to apply insecticide or pesticide once in a month. This is the point number 5. So hope you like the video. If you like the video, please give it a like, give it a thumbs up. If you want to share, please share with your near and dear ones. If you are very new to my channel, please subscribe my channel. I'm going to give you lots about the Adenium growing and caring and all. Thank you very much. Thank you for being with us. So nice of you. Thank you.